think generally speaking, in this country, that generally speaking, opera gets a fairly bad press. And so many people believe what they're told about opera, either through mainstream media or something like that, that we are all, and even the people involved in it, like me, are elitist snobs with wobbly voices. And we drive around in limos and we wear fur coats and silk scarves. And I mean, sometimes I'm shocked at what people think I do and how my life is. They say, gosh, I saw Brindley Sherratt in Waitrose. I go shopping, you know, I mean, I'm not, you know, you know, we're normal people. And I think I really would say, go to an opera before you judge it, before you judge what it's like. And if there could be more things like this that show that, you know, the wires behind the TV or behind the stereo set in the corner to see how it's put together, the people involved, you'll see that we're not elitist snobs. Yes, there are some divas, but that's fun. You know, but there are divas in the office. You know, I've known people who are IT consultants who are huge divas. Yes, there are people like that, but generally speaking, we're really committed to what we do. We believe in what we do and we love what we do. So don't judge us by what you're told. Go and see an opera. And go see something big. Save up and go see something big at Covent Garden or English National Opera in London, or if you're in, wherever you are, go to a big opera house near you. Save up, have dinner, dress up, go to the opera, have a great time. But then go and see something like opera up close, or where you can actually see singers, you know, coming next to you while they're singing. And then you get to hear the human voice in your ear, unamplified. So go to something big, go to something small. Do a little prep. I talked about this earlier. Do a bit of prep, what's going on, and go and see one before you make any judgments about it. I'm not an elitist. I come from a council estate in Greater Manchester where there were no opportunities to step into. My dad was a lorry driver. My mum worked as a secretary, and we lived in a council house. There were no privileges afforded to me. And I don't want to do the sob story, you know. But you know, we're not elitist snobs, and not all from very privileged backgrounds. We're people who can just sing.